Hello again, everybody. I'm Trish Triumpho Sullivan, and I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the parts of a camera. So we need to know all the working parts of a camera. They're the same in every kind of camera, whether it's a film camera or a digital camera. And even in automatic point and shoot cameras, they have all these different parts that function to make an exposure, which is what a photograph is. It's called an exposure or an image. So when you hear the words image or exposure, you know we're talking about a photo, right? An actual photograph. So the parts of the camera, we're gonna talk a little bit about that. So the first part of the camera you wanna think about or know about is called the body. So the body of the camera is this part here, right? That's the part that all the pieces are in, right? So when you're looking at that, at a camera, you can see that the body is this kind of boxy part here, right? That's part number one. The second part you need to know is the lens. There's the lens right there, okay? So those are the two basic parts of a camera. Pretty straightforward, right? Then we come to a little bit more complicated, but it's not really complicated, you guys. The parts of a camera are actually pretty simple compared to, say, a car engine, right? So if you can understand a little bit about a car engine, you can understand a camera without any problem, okay? Or even a bicycle. If you know what the parts of a bicycle, you can understand the parts of a camera, okay? So we've got the body and the lens. Now, inside the body and the lens are two of the controls that are the most important controls in your camera, right? One is called the aperture, which is normally located inside the lens. It's a series of overlapping metal leaves, okay, that can change the opening in size. Okay, it's like a little diaphragm, so it can open or close to make a very small hole or a bigger hole for the light to come in through the lens. So the light comes in through the lens, and you can change the size of that aperture. So the aperture is normally located inside the lens. The other really important part of the camera is called the shutter. And the shutter is right back here. It's usually inside the body in front of what we call the film plane. So if you had a camera that had film in it, it would be stretched across the back of the camera, right, on a roll on each end. Okay, and then in front of that film plane where the film is, or in a digital camera where the sensor is, right, that's what's recording it, is the sensor that makes the exposure, is what we call the shutter. So the shutter opens and closes to let the light that comes through the lens hit the where the image is recorded, which is the film or the, it's either film or a digital media, the sensor. So you've got the aperture and the shutter, and you have to have a way to control them, okay? In old-timey cameras, which this is a picture of an old-time camera because I wanted you guys to see how the most simple mechanisms of the camera work without looking at digital yet. Digital, it's harder to see the controls because they're controlled you see them on the LED screen in the back, okay? Or LCD screen. So to control the aperture, you have what we call an aperture ring that goes around the outside of the lens, and you turn it, you can see there's little numbers on it, and those numbers represent different sizes of the aperture. That's it, it's pretty simple, right? And we'll go into this in more detail. But you have what you call an aperture ring on the lens that you can turn and change the size of the opening to how much light's going to get in through the lens. The other little ring here is called a focus ring. That's the one where you see people going like this on the camera. They're focusing, so they're changing they're focusing the camera. So I'm going to put it close up there so you can kind of see my little drawing. I drew a lens, and I drew an aperture ring with some F numbers on it. And then the focus ring, which is right there, that we would change to make sure that whatever you're doing is in sharp focus, right? So that's the control for the aperture. That's that one important part. Then we have the shutter. There's a control for that up here, right? And you know, almost all cameras have the little button that you push down. That's called the shutter release button. So on this camera, it's right up top on the ring that also controls the shutter speed. So the shutter opens and closes when you push down that shutter release button on your camera. Pretty simple still, right? It's all parts that we understand. It's not hard. And so when you press that down, the shutter opens, the light comes through, exposes your media, whether it's film or digital, right? And then it closes. And so up here, you also have a little dial with some numbers on it. And those numbers represent the speed that the shutter opens and closes. Either opens really fast, or it opens really slow, or somewhere in between. Right? Straightforward so far? Yeah, pretty much. So then, right in behind it, we have what we call the film advance lever, and that would be if you had a film camera, you would move that forward to advance the film. Okay, so this is a fully manual, you know, SLR camera. On the other side, you'd have a dial that sets the ISO and a film rewind, right? So when the film stops, you would rewind it onto the roll, take it out of the camera, and take it in to get developed, okay? So you would also, in these types of cameras, you would also in the back have an eyepiece that you would look through, right, to see what is coming through the lens, what your subject is, what you're taking a photograph of, right? So you'd have on the back, you'd have like a little eye hole that you could peek through and you could see what you're looking at. Okay, those are so far the basic parts of the camera. You've got the body, the lens, the aperture, the shutter, right? The aperture ring to control the size of the aperture, the focus ring to focus, the shutter release button and the shutter speed control, the film advance lever, okay, and the ISO control here. Am I missing anything? The shutter control, film advance lever, blah, blah, blah. No, I think I pretty much got it all. So let's talk about one last thing. So where the film is or the sensor is in the back of the camera is called the film plane. We'll talk about that. I would write that down if I were you, because the film plane is something we talk about when we're talking about lens sizes and those kind of things. So that's kind of and also the aperture sizes. It'll help you to understand if you just know the film plane is where the image is recorded, whether it's a film or sensor. Now, if you're looking at a more modern camera, you have all these same controls. They're all there, except you're looking at them on a screen, right? You have a little window on the back of your camera, and it will have the sizes of the aperture and the speed of the shutter, which are both represented by different numbers, okay? And they're controlled usually by some dials on the back. There might be a few buttons. The reason it's hard to say that for a digital SLR, a DSLR, it's a little hard to say because every camera is different. Now, it'd be great if every brand made their cameras so that it was easy, like cross brands, it was easy to say, this is where this is where that is, yada, yada, but it's not. Every single camera brand has a different style. They have buttons in a different place. The only thing they're going to have in common is their little viewing screen on the back. Okay. Now, even with a viewing screen where you can see the photograph you're taking, I always recommend looking through the eyepiece because the resolution on the viewing screen is not as good as actually seeing with your eye. Okay. So anyway, these are the parts of the camera, and that's your lecture on camera parts. See you in class.